Hey gang, Steve with Guitar Center. We're at NAMM 2023 in the secret lair of Ernie Ball Music Man, and we're going to check out all the latest new guitars with AJ. How you doing, AJ?
Doing great.
Are you having a good NAMM since you can get off the floor and get into a quiet space?
Really enjoying the lair, but you know, NAMM's a once-a-year thing that there's nothing else like it, so nice. Love it.
All right, so let's start with the biggest news, the Kaizen.
We've got... not only three new colors, but we've got a six-string version here. The new colors are going to be a mint, an indigo, and a chalk. They're going to be limited edition, limited to 60 for six-string and 60 for seven-string of each color. The Apollo Black that I hold in my hands here is going to be an ongoing offering. In case anybody's not familiar with this guitar, it's a brand new design from us that we developed last year in collaboration with Tosin Abbasi of Animals as Leaders. From the ground up, every part of this guitar, aside from the strap buttons and some screws, it's brand new. From the knobs to the multi-scale tremolo, the infinity fretboard radius that allows for greater visibility of the fretboard, the multi-scale length design of the fretboard. So you've got a 24 3/4 inch scale for your treble strings and a 25 1/2 inch with some more tension for your bass strings. HT pickup, custom wound offset mini humbucker up in the neck. And it is just super comfortable. It hugs your body like you're sitting in a sports car.
Really nice. So in terms of the development process, when you guys are making something that is brand new, how does that work? Is it like prototype city?
It is prototype city. And with an artist like Tosin, it's going to be sending guitars back and forth, sometimes bringing them to him, getting feedback, going back to the drawing board, reevaluating what we've done and working on minor changes. And just depends on, you know, what the artist wants, how quickly it's done.
Yeah, that's really cool. And so how vociferous or how loud was the call for a six-string version?
I really wanted one. But yeah, we intended on doing both out of the gate. But launched with the seven with the idea that the six is coming right behind it. So that was always the intention to have a six also.
The difference then, let's say, on the multi-scale between the six and the seven, can you describe what we're looking at distance-wise there?
Yeah, so the seven, the scale length will be the same for the six strings, as I mentioned, 24 3/4 on your high E, 25 1/2 on your low E, and then on the low B, it's 25.65. So even a little bit more length there for the lower tuning, the bigger tension.
Nice. And so we also have a couple other new guitars here. What else do we got?
We've got some Luke 4 guitars that we'd like to show you next.
Okay, so we're back now with the Luke 4, the L4. What is the official title?
So this is the Luke 4 30th anniversary model. So it's very rare for a company to work with an artist for 30 years, but we've been lucky enough to work with Luke, who's not only a great guitar player, but just a great one-of-a-kind guy. This model encompasses features of his various models over the years. Tried to put that all into one. So we've got a double locking tremolo like his original model that's recessed, so fully floating. You're able to raise that open G string up a step and a half. Features a HSS pickup configuration. What's a little different on this is they're our new HT pickups, the heat treated pickups. They have a very wide frequency range response, a lot of output, but they clean up very nice when you roll back the volume. You've got a nice maple top here, a black limba back, which is very cool, roasted figured maple neck, and these are going to be limited to 150 units for the whole world. So celebrating 30 years of our partnership with Steve Lukather.
Can you describe for me what the process is on heat treating pickups?
I actually can't, but I can give you a nice distilled version of the science. it kind of was born out of our exploration into different alloys with strings. You know, you're familiar with the cobalt strings, the M-steel strings, and how those different metals react with the magnets of the pickup to increase your output and give you a different sound. We kind of turned the tables on that and applied that science to the pickups themselves, so that they're working more efficiently rather than using off-the-shelf materials that most pickups are made from that are used in a myriad of other industries. The materials in our pickups, the HT pickups, are made specifically for guitar pickups, so the pickups operate more efficiently.
Really cool. Very high tech.
It is. A little over my head, even.
Well, that's what's really cool about what you guys have going on. It's sort of like the tradition of guitar building, but like very, very cutting edge of technology.
Yeah, you know, we like to marry both the craftsmanship of kind of not old school ways, but traditional ways, like you said, with modern sciences and modern technologies, and try to push the envelope for what an electric guitar can and should do.
All right, so our next guitar is another Luke.
Yeah, we've got our regular line of Luke 4s we'll show you.
Woo-wee! AJ, what the heck is that color?
Well, we've got Gator Burst here on a new Luke 4 HH model featuring the HT pickups. You've got a nice figured maple top here, rosewood fretboard, roasted figured maple neck, and an Akume body. Five-way pickup selector for a myriad of different sounds, and you've also got the 12 dB gain boost accessible with the push tone bot.
Really cool. So when you guys, over 30 years working with Luke, is there any kind of wild request or surprise that he's brought up where you guys are like, we can't do that, or how could we do that, you know?
Not really. Luke is actually one of the easiest guys to work with when it comes to designing guitars. And to be honest, we were looking at refreshing the line of Luke 3 colors, and he got a hold of some guitars with the HT pickups, and that's how we decided to do the Luke 4.
Wow, that's really cool. So he just sort of discovered something you guys were working on on the side, not necessarily for him specifically, and he just sort of grabbed onto it?
That's it. Yeah, he really liked the HT pickups, so we integrated them into his line, and the Luke 4 was born.
Well, I mean, that's pretty much a testament to the HT pickups if Steve Lukather is like, hey, you know what? These are so good, I want them in my guitar.
Yeah, I did the same thing. They're in my guitars now, too.
All right, so that's a Luke 4 HH. What's coming up next?
We've got a Luke 4 SSS.
So, AJ, this is a sweet finish on this SSS. What is this color called?
So this is Scoville Red. Also available in diesel blue. This is a Luke 4 model. It's the first time that we've done three single coils on a Luke. Able to get away with that because they are the new HT technology pickups. Aside from that, it's going to have a lot of the features that any Luke player is familiar with, the 12-inch radius, rosewood fretboard. The body is alder, but it's roasted alder this time. And you've got a roasted maple neck. It's got the boost that's set to 12 dB gain boost, clean gain boost from the factory, adjustable internally in the guitar to over 20.
When you guys decide you're going to put out a three single coil version, what process happens to make that reality?
Well, Luke got a hold of a Cutlass HT that has the three single coil pickups and decided that he wanted to integrate that into his line. It wasn't a lot of trouble for the engineers to redesign the body routes to accommodate those pickups, and we were off to the races.
Pretty cool. So what's coming up next? Are we going to Basstown?
We're going to Basstown.
Woo-wee! AJ, that is a pretty sweet-looking bass.
Well, thanks a bunch. It's one of our new Stingray special colors. This one is Laguna Green. We also have a Buttercream, a Sea Breeze, and a Pueblo Pink, each with matching headstock, rosewood fretboard, and select hardwood body.
Very cool. So with the Stingray Special versus the Stingray, what sort of differences are we looking at there specs-wise?
Well, we've got stainless steel frets as opposed to the nickel frets of the Stingray of yesteryear. We went from an Al Nico pickup to neodymium, from a 9-volt preamp to 18-volt for some extra headroom. And it still retains that Stingray sound, that DNA that the Stingray player is looking for, but it goes above and beyond a little bit more. On top of that, we went with a smaller bridge, some aluminum hardware here, and a change to the tuners to allow for some weight relief.
So it gets a lot lighter, but it also gets a lot heavier?
Exactly. Available in 4-string, 5-string, with 1 humbucker or 2 humbuckers.
Very cool. Thank you, AJ, for running us through all these awesome instruments. And there you have it, gang. Ernie Ball Music Man, latest lineup coming soon to Guitar Center near you or guitarcenter.com.